to go on YouTube. My name is Blake Yarbrough and welcome back. Today we've got an early look at an upcoming Nike Air Force One Low in collaboration with Drake or the NOCTA brand. So we've got this powder blue. It's actually called Cobalt Tint. You've got this light blue, powder blue box. Looks amazing. I really like this color when it comes to sneakers. So happy to see the box in this color. On the top of the box lid, you've got the Nike Air Force One logo with Love You Forever in a script font in gold on top of that. Looks very cool, very Drake-esque. And then on the bottom of the box right here, it says in association with NOCTA, again, Drake's collection with Nike. So here we have the box. Now, before I open this box, if you enjoy this video, please leave a like down below. Consider subscribing if you like it as well. 95% of you guys are not subscribed currently. We've got the inside of the box here. I did get these from Goat, and you've got this special Nike NOCTA paper with the Nike swoosh and the NOCTA logo as well. And here we have the Nike Air Force One Low in collaboration with Drake. Ain't really Lee, but I'm back. I'm riding around in Atlanta with Sav, cause that nigga been going harder than me. Nothing to change, I'm just harder to please. Ferrari is making an SUV. We ain't got a choice, we ordering these. Shout out Noel for recording the V's. He know where this shit about to go, cause nobody touching the flow. They say you alone at the top, but it's gotta be lonely below. So this shoe right here is set to release in the next week, week and a half, depending on when this video gets posted. And I'm a big fan of it. It is just a white Nike Air Force One, right? But there are actually several differences, which we'll talk about here in the video. And I'll let you know what I think about the shoe. Honestly, I really like it. I think it's a cool shoe. It's obviously very similar to the standard Nike Air Force One Low, but we'll go ahead and start with the outsole. Now, the biggest detail, kind of the controversy around this shoe releasing, was on the outsole right here around the toe and around the heel, where you would normally have stars. They replaced it with hearts, so the tread pattern is actually in the shape of hearts. Looks really sick. It's not a huge detail, it's not super noticeable or anything like that. They are very small, but it is a nice touch from Drake and Nike. Moving up the midsole, of course, usually you'd have air right here. It says Love You Forever, just like the box lid, in that script font. I think that looks absolutely, it's just cool. Like, I really like Drake. My brother is probably a bigger Drake fan. These are for him, so he's super excited for these. This is, I think, just an awesome shoe to own because it's simple, it's clean. A lot of the shoes that Nike has released with Drake have been that. They've been simple whites, blacks, with subtle details, which I like that. So this one right here, you've got Love You Forever on the midsole. Actually, on the inside of the foot, you've got the air right there. And that's about it when it comes to the outsole and midsole. Other than that, it's standard Air Force One. And then the upper, there's a lot of different on the upper. The first thing you might notice is the texture of the leather. High quality tumbled leather. So these have a different leather than what you would get on the standard Air Force One. You can see on the toe box, it's a much softer leather. I like that. I haven't owned any Air Force Ones like this with the tumbled leather. I've only owned the standard smooth leather that creases like crazy. So I'm curious to see how these wear in. I know my brother's gonna wear them, so we'll kind of get a look at that. But the quality of the leather is good. Around on the heel, you've got the NOCTA logo there on the back. That's the left shoe. On the right shoe, you do have that Nike Air branding. Looking at the inside of the shoe, you've got a white leather sock liner. So again, a premium material on the sock liner as opposed to the standard mesh. And then the insole right there, you can see the Nike branding as well as NOCTA. And it's in that same color, that cobalt tint, the light powder blue, just like the box. Nice touch. Just a little pop of color there on the insole. And then probably the coolest detail about this sneaker, there's actually two. One's cooler than the other one, but right here on the laces, at the bottom of the laces, you've got this metal piece, and that's called a Yarbrough. So this comes standard on Air Force Ones. It also comes on shoes like the Cortez and some other various Nike models, but this is called a Yarbrough. And so as advertised, you do get a bag of beads that you can put on the sneaker. Now, this is probably also in that same cobalt tint blue. And unfortunately, it looks like you're only going to get the beads like A through Z and 1 through 9 or 0 through 9. And so it's kind of unfortunate that you're not gonna have duplicates of like some vowels and things like that. I think that is a downer. So you would need to
probably purchase or find some similar beads, and it's not that big a deal. I'm sure a lot of people are just gonna use regular beads on these shoes. It doesn't have to be this pack of beads, but for me, I would want them all to match, and so it is a little bit of a bummer that you're only getting like A through Z. The other detail that is different is you've got this set of white flat laces with metal aglets that screw on, just like some other sneakers we've seen in the past from Nike. So you've got these extra tips, and you've got screw-on aglets for the laces. So those are all the details. That's all the differences when it comes to this sneaker. What do you guys think? Is this a must cop? For me, I really want a pair of these just to collect. Would I wear them? I could wear them, but I'd probably just wear like a regular $100 pair of Air Force Ones that I don't care what happens to. And I'd rather keep these nice. Now I'd probably wear them eventually, but it'd be more of a special occasion type sneaker than it would be an everyday type wear or oftentimes wear. Other than that, the prices right now are sitting around the low 200s. I think it's a decent price. It's not too much over retail, and I think it's a great shoe. Happy to see these actually releasing, because there's a big rumor that they were not going to release due to manufacturing on the hearts. So glad to see Nike work out the details on this sneaker, Drake and Nike, new Air Force One. Let me know what you guys think down in the comments. If you're new to the channel, please consider subscribing, or if you've been around for a while, hit that subscribe button down below. And with that, we're on to the next sneaker.